Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of The L Spot Show.
Yes.
We are your hosts, Camille J.
And Angela Yvonne.
And we have an exciting episode for you guys today. We are going to be talking about veganism and clean eating because our queen of the vegans over here is trying to convert every last one of us, including myself, over to the vegan side. And I am reluctant, but we'll see how it goes. You guys will see a special journey that
we
went on, and it's going to be an exciting one. And we're going to have a very special guest. Miss LeA Robinson is going to stop by. She's going to tell us about her career in music, her life on the show on Bravo TV, and she's also a vegan. Would you look at that?
Yes.
So she's going to be telling us about her eating and all of that good stuff. So make sure you guys stay tuned. This is The L Spot Show.
Yes.
Now watch me work.
Welcome back. We are here with LeA Robinson, granddaughter of legendary Sylvia Robinson, founder of Sugar Hill Records, and she is a vegan.
Hey.
Yay!
Yes.
Hey.
Yes, my vegan sister.
Welcome to the show.
And Camille is over here. She's a carnivore.
Okay, all right. It's all right.
Shade already.
We don't pass any judgment because the thing with being a vegan, I feel like we have a bad rep.
Yes.
People be like, oh, if you're a vegan, we be trying to convert everybody, which is true.
That is true.
But it's only because we care for y'all. We want y'all bodies to
is
be clean inside out. We want y'all to have this vegan glow like how we glow. That's
Look,
it.
All right.
I'm 180.
Same.
Okay.
I love my meat. All right. I just love it. I love it.
We gonna get there one
day.
We'll
see. I'm down. I'm very open to hearing about what you guys got to say to see if I can step over to that side.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yes. Spit it to me.
I had the honor of taking Miss Camille out for her first vegan venture.
Yes.
We took her to Urban Vegan Kitchen.
Okay. How did
and
that go?
How did it go?
You guys will see soon. The clip will play, but it was definitely not what I thought.
Yeah.
I was very...
In a good way?
In a good way. Okay. In a good way. I thought, like, I'm going to be eating air chips and ice crackers.
Everybody, as a vegan, I feel like everybody always asks, so what do you eat? I'm like, there's so much more to eat besides meat.
Absolutely. So what kind of vegan are you? Because I know that there's raw veganism, there's dietary vegan, there's
extreme
vegan.
What are the differences?
Well, raw veganism is that you don't eat anything up to 118 degrees. You don't cook the food?
Like, it's not cooked.
It's not cooked.
I'm not even going to lie to you. I don't know.
Okay. Well, that's the truth.
Like,
that's
the truth. That
and then there's vegan, then there's regular vegans who are just, you know, where they're like, they eat cooked meat. Not cooked meat, but they eat
food.
Like cooked food.
Yeah.
So what is the definition of a vegan?
I think everybody's definition. Yeah, it's a plant-based, but everybody kind of makes it their own thing.
Okay.
Absolutely.
I'm not even going to lie. In the beginning, I was a flexa vegan.
Yeah.
Like, I was eating my vegan foods, but
right.
I love pizza too. So I was
Me
still
too.
Like,
Me too.
Two roast pizza, dollar pizza.
Right.
Ooh. Like,
right.
I was on that tip. Still trying to master it completely, but I just like to feel good.
Mm-hmm.
I like to be able to survive off of less hours of sleep. And
yes.
Being a vegan, that's so easy for me. I like to walk out the house with no makeup and like feel like my skin is glowing, my hair is growing, everything.
Mm-hmm.
And just, I feel good. Like when I was eating meat, that was the only time that I would get sick.
Yep.
I do not miss that. I don't miss getting food poison, any
yep.
of that. And that's honestly what made me become a vegetarian because I was eating McDonald's. And I got so sick.
Yeah.
And I was at a studio session. I had to sleep at my producer's crib and just knock out because I couldn't move. I was like, I don't like this feeling.
Yeah.
When I turned vegan, I haven't gotten sick.
It's just a whole other world has opened up.
Yeah.
And like, I'm newly vegan. Like, newly. I'm not newly like, oh my God, yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm newly vegan and I have yes, we're going to bring her
we
over.
We love you, though.
We're going to bring
yes,
her
no
over.
Love.
But the positive side of being vegan is, like you said, I get better sleep.
Yes.
I can eat as much as I want
yeah.
because the calories. And I'm learning how to cook. So now I can get me a husband.
Yeah. You know what? And if you ever need some recipes, I got you.
Absolutely.
Here's my thing
Absolutely.
About vegan, right? And even when we went out to
yes.
the food, which you guys will see soon. what like bothers me a little bit is that you guys are still calling it, like, how could we have chicken and waffles? But we're not eating chicken. So
it's
you can't
un-chicken.
Call it
chicken. It's like chickpeas. So yeah. It technically is. Or like right.
Or bacon. We had something like some type of bacon, but it's not bacon. Why are you
because you know
it
what?
Bacon?
You know why I think they do that? Because I think that if you see something that's completely unfamiliar, right. Your brain automatically goes, oh my God, this is going to taste terrible.
Right.
Oh my God, this is not going to taste like bacon. In your head, you're going into it like, all right, this is not going to taste like what I'm thinking. So it's like... Food is mental also.
Absolutely. Right?
And I totally believe that. So I think that's why they do it. But it's still good.
Absolutely.
I'm like, y'all tricking me. It almost looked like chicken. Mm-hmm. But I'm like, this ain't chicken. And y'all telling me chicken and waffles.
But that's why you have to have an open mind. Yes. Because I think a lot of people don't convert to veganism because they fear that they're going to miss out.
Yes.
But I was explaining to her that with cooking vegan, it's all about how you season it.
It completely is. But I love it. And it's making me cook more, too, because I don't like to eat out a lot. I'm very iffy about my food. I don't really trust a lot of people when it comes to preparing my food, especially if I can't see it. Mm-hmm. And then I've been lied to so many times also. Like, I asked the chef, like, so what is in this? Are you cooking it on the same grill that you're cooking the regular chicken and stuff on? Right. And they'll lie, and my body responds within minutes.
Yes.
So I'm like, bruh, like, you don't know what a person can be allergic to or anything, so you can't really mix those two things. So it's a little struggle.
I can say, though, I feel like it definitely is becoming more popular. There's more places to eat. Like, you're saying you don't like to go out to eat that much. But what I think about it is, like, where can you go to eat? Like, if you are out, where can you go? What restaurants you can go? So I like that it is becoming more popular.
Yeah.
Even there's a lot more restaurants around. And also, regular restaurants are also having, like,
vegan option
or gluten-free option. So I think as far as that, I think that's good. Because my sister, she's not a full vegan. She's, a pescatarian, so she eats fish. But when she first started, she was having a lot of problems. We would go out to a restaurant, and she's like, I can't eat. I'm just going to sit here, which that sucks. Like, no one wants to be out or they can't eat.
Yeah.
And she's in college, so she's not, like, at home cooking every day.
Right.
So I think that there are more restaurants and different places that are participating, I think that's good.
Yeah,
so,
me too.
Y'all don't got to be at home all the time.
But you know what? I like to, like, I don't eat that much anyways. Like, I eat so much throughout the day, I kind of space out my food.
Mm-hmm.
So even when I do go out to restaurants that don't necessarily have, like, a vegan option, I always do, like, the sides are always good for me. I'm like, I love French fries. That's something I will love to the day I die. So I'm just like, French fries it is. That's my go-to. But, yeah, it's not that difficult. And I think with being a vegan, too, or just eating cleaner and healthier, meal prep is, like, so key.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you always have to have, like, your little snacks with you. Like,
absolutely.
I get hungry consistently every hour or every 2 hours. So I have to have, like, walnuts or fruit or something with me so it keeps my body going. And that's also why my metabolism is like that.
Yeah.
My vegan sister. No. Okay. Okay.
So what are some key recipes that you guys like?
Yeah.
Let's see, what do I do a lot? I like cooking, like, the vegan burgers. I love Beyond Meat. Those are really good because I know how to flavor my food really, really well to where, like, people don't even know that it's vegan.
Right.
I cooked for my friend one time, and I just gave her the food without even telling her that it was vegan. She was like, oh my God, this is so good. Oh, I was like, yeah, it's vegan, girl. That's vegan. She didn't even know.
You're not even eating no meat.
Right. And so, then I love pesto also. Like, I found a really good, great pesto. So that was fantastic. And I use quinoa noodles also, which are really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all, it's like you said, how you flavor it.
Yeah.
Like quinoa noodles.
Yeah. There's brown rice noodles.
Yeah.
There's
cauliflower.
Broccoli.
Putting the people on, okay?
So what are some of your hot spots that you like to eat around here in New York?
I love Chloe's.
Yes, Chloe's is everything.
Chloe's is, like, fantastic. Like, and their cupcakes were bomb. I'm such a dessert person.
Me too.
I love sugar. I love sweets. So to know that it's vegan, it doesn't mean that there is, like, less sugar in there because the sugar can be crazy, but it just makes me feel better about it. I don't feel, like, crazy about it. I'm like, oh, 12 cupcakes, that's fine.
That is so fine.
So, yeah, I like it.
A lot, anytime people mention vegan, Chloe's is a spot that people always
because it's like, so
have
dope.
Have you been to Chloe's? Have you been to Chloe's?
Yeah.
So I guess that gotta be the next
You gotta come to Chloe's.
So good.
You gotta come to Chloe's.
The L spot, dinner at Chloe's.
Yes.
Can I join?
Yes.
Y'all heard them say right?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. So to get back to, you know, the beginnings with you becoming vegan and, of course, the health benefits, but What do you want people to know about being vegan, even though we've said so much, in order, like, if you had 2 seconds
to persuade someone
why they need to be a vegan, give me what you would say.
I would say you are what you eat. That's it.
You know what? You better not be no Burger King burger.
Listen, right. You better be a Chloe's. You better be a Chloe's, okay?
Preach to the people.
You are what you eat, though. I genuinely feel that. Like, because I know that when I was eating fast food, how that made me feel. I felt sluggish. I felt like I had the itis. I felt like I had to go right to sleep. When I eat this way, I'm like, it just gives me energy.
Yeah.
So it just, like, I feel good waking up. I don't feel heavy, and I don't miss that feeling.
Yeah.
Oh. All right. It sounds a little
Come on,
good.
Nova. Come on, Nova. Come over.
We'll see. We'll see. I'm going to have to be the flexive vegan, you know.
The flexive vegan. It's okay.
I'm a weekend vegan.
You got to start from somewhere. You got to start from somewhere. That's okay.
That is too funny. Mm-hmm. So we will be right back because we have so much more to talk to LeA about. Yeah. And make sure you stay tuned to the L Spot Show. Here at the Urban Vegan Kitchen near West 4th in New York City. And I'm here to convert my co-host Camille to eating the plant-based life. Veganism is a way of life to where you only eat plant-based. Some may argue that they're going to miss out on their meats, that there's not a lot of options, but today I'm going to show you and Camille that vegan is life. So let's go.
Oh. This is the mac and cheese.
It looks good.
It's super good. It's made from cashew cheese. It has shiitake bacon, which is made from mushrooms. It also has a new moon mozzarella, which is dairy-free. So go ahead and dig in. Dig in.
Very creamy.
Uh-huh.
It's good though. It wasn't what I was expecting at first. It is like it's a flavor that's in there.
Right, it's nutty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's almost like a little sweet, but it's good.
So would you try it again?
Yeah.
It's chicken and waffles. We have a little bit of kale. We have a little bit of fried seitan, fried southern style, and we have a Belgian waffle with an aioli on it. And then we, of course, have syrup on the side.
It looks really good.
Yes.
It looks really good.
Smells good.
It looks like chicken fingers.
Yes.
So the fact that it's not... It's very choppy.
Okay.
Let's see how it tastes.
All right. And of course, I want you to go first. Because I live
this life.
Yes.
All right. Copy a nice pink here.
Yeah.
It's not chicken?
No. It's not chicken.
Okay. It tastes like it could be chicken fingers though.
It's all about the seasoning, it's about the flour. Like I was saying before, a lot of the vegan food is mostly about what you season the food with. Because it can take on the taste of anything, like with tofu. Tofu by itself is super bland, but if you add cumin and turmeric, peppers and onions, mushrooms, it's a whole nother lifestyle.
I mean, if you could have told me, I probably would have known.
Yes.
This could pass for actual chicken and waffles.
Yes.
Which is the scary part, that all this trying to, it doesn't taste that far off from the real thing.
Absolutely. And that's why when people say that they don't have options or they're going to miss meat, you won't miss no meat. You had the mac and cheese, you had the chicken and waffles, and now to top it all off, you are going to have a vegan dessert. Now you have had the whole gamut from the beginning to the end. You gotta taste this.
Right? Dig in.
So, what yes. kind of ice cream is this?
This is made from coconut.
Oh, wow.
Yes. And this is, the brownie is made with cacao. Wow. Okay.
Creamy.
Yes.
And I can also tell that they must have really used like raw chocolate.
Yes.
Because it has like that earthy, dusty kind of flavoring. But it still tastes good though.
But you know dark chocolate is very good for you.
Better for you than real chocolate.
Yes.
No. Yeah. It's a little tougher.
Yeah.
Than like a,
yeah.
A little regular brownie. But it still tastes very chocolate.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you can get your sweet fix. And all of this is what? Meatless, no dairy, you had soy free. You need to come on over to the green side, Camille. Come on over, at least once a week. This is One for the Books with Camille, and I'm coming for you guys as well. Veganism is a lifestyle. If you're feeling like you're on the fence about everything, you don't have to do it cold turkey. It's been proven that living this lifestyle is very beneficial. It's over 600% of people are converting over the next 3 years. Those are huge numbers. I'm Angela Yvonne, and I'm a vegan. Make sure you tune into the L Spot, where you too can network and be recognized. Let me get up in this.
Hey girl, enjoy.
Mm-hmm. So we got the vegan stuff out the way.
Absolutely.
Can we move on just a little bit? We want to get to know more about you and your career. You've been doing so many amazing things.
Thank you.
So let's get into some of that.
Yes.
Of course, many people know you now from the Bravo show.
Mm-hmm.
How is life after that?
Honestly, stuff like that, like, it doesn't excite me. I'm just a good person. And that was honestly like why I was sad about the show. I think that they didn't showcase that
right.
enough. My life, I love my normal life. Like I enjoy going on stage, doing what I do, and coming back home and being in my sweatpants and washing my face off and recording and being normal. So like, I think people have a choice. They can either make their life really, really chaotic and crazy, or
right.
they can make their life really normal. I choose to make my life really normal and simple.
Yeah.
I love a simple life. I love being with the people that I love. I love going to Barnes & Noble and reading a book. I love going to the library. I love going to go get coffee. Like, those are things I love.
Right.
So I think you have a choice, and my choice is to keep life as simple as possible, but still be great.
Has your life changed at all since the show?
Got some more bookings, you know?
Yeah.
Bookings is nice.
Booked and busy.
A little bit more followers.
Yeah, you know? But, like, I always said this. The show didn't make me.
Right.
And regardless of if I'm on television or not, I'm going to be successful. So, honestly, the things that I did on the show was the things that I did before the show. So, honestly, it just was the same, but I just was more active.
But how important do you feel was it to have your family's legacy showcased on national TV, and especially on a network like Bravo?
Yeah.
Because to be honest, they don't really have a lot of African-American shows.
For sure.
And then to also to showcase a show where it's representing African-Americans, it's also talking about hip-hop.
Yes.
And it's not showing fighting or glasses being thrown or all that other stuff that we do see from a lot of reality shows that feature African-Americans. So how was that for you to be a part of something like that?
Honestly, the only reason truly why I did it was because it allowed people to see my grandmother's story, and I thought that that needed to be showcased. When we first did the pilot of the show, I didn't even know it was going to happen. I just did it. I was like, oh, whatever. It's a pilot. It's not going to happen. Then it happened. I was like, oh, my God, it's happening. So, I really, truly did it just to keep my grandma's legacy alive, because I know that reality television is something that I enjoy watching. But I'm not sure if I would ever do it again unless I'm executive producer of the show.
Right.
I did it to keep my grandmother's name alive, and that's my plan.
Nice.
Well, being part of such a strong legacy, the first hip-hop label, how was that growing up? Just knowing, like, was you, like, popping collars? Were you just like...
Not at all.
Let me break it down for you guys who don't know history.
No, like, I'm so not that person at all. And I'll be quiet and I'll let somebody else say it before I even say it. And to be completely 1,000, I didn't even know who my family was or what they did until I was like 16 years old, because it was a family. My grandma kept us so normal. So my grandma was just my grandma. It wasn't like, do you know who your grandma is? Like, being around legendary people was like semi-normal to us. Like, Ronald Isley lived across the street from us and would just come over and I would sing for them. But that was like our norm.
Right.
So I definitely was never about the, do you know who I am? Like, I never was on that. And I'm not that person. So... Nice. I mean, I gotta pull that car sometimes.
Of course,
sometimes,
you know? If you don't,
but
can't be mad at that. Don't waste your blessings. But don't waste your blessings
for the majority. Right, I keep it cool. I keep it cool.
So, how do you feel about coming from such a legendary place, and now we have this type of hip hop now? Because hip hop then was like hardcore, like the truth tellers, making you feel it, making you want to go into actions, lyricists, to right now we got scat.
You know what? I have a weird feeling about this, because, yes, that was the start of hip-hop. That was, like, the brand, the stamp of it. But I have, like, an issue with people that say, like, this generation's hip-hop is not real hip-hop. I'm like, you can't say that necessarily, because just because Chief Keef is rapping about something that you don't necessarily understand, that doesn't mean it's not real hip-hop to his culture and to the people that understand his life.
Right.
So just like how people view Nas and Biggie, they connected with them because that was their real life. So that was real hip-hop to them. But there's a billion fans that understand Chief Keef and Lil Uzi that don't understand Jay-Z and Nas, and they don't understand that.
Right.
So it's just like, I am all for people creating and doing what's authentically them. If that's authentically you, then do you. Because then we want to say that they're fake and that they're being somebody that they're not when they try to be all lyrical and like Jay and like Pac and like all these people, and that's not really them. So I just tell people to create and do them. That's how you win. And regardless of what you do, somebody's going to feel some type of way about it. Somebody's going to say something. You could discover the cure for cancer today or tomorrow, and people are going to be like, why did you do that? Do you know how much money you're causing us to lose?
Yeah.
Like, it's like, yo, but I'm saving billions of people.
Right.
But people are going to talk regardless. So I just say people need to just be themselves, and however they win is how they win.
Mm, definitely. So we have some music coming out, don't you?
Yes, and it's good music, too. It's so good. It's so good.
So tell us a little bit about that. What's going on with it?
It's so good. Okay, so my album is called Broken Girl.
Mm.
It is so personal, so amazing. And I have to give a shout out to my manager, because he really, like, he trusted me to really go into this and do it myself and be, like, authentic with myself and how I was feeling at the time. And I really felt broken at the time that I was recording this album. And I was like, you know what? People really like to stray away from that. And I'm like, that's how you grow. That's the beautiful part about someone's story to me, is them telling that. Yeah. I don't want to know about your success. I want to know about how you got there. That's what's important to me. So I felt broken at a certain point. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to share this with the world and be vulnerable. And I was like, that's when it's real. And I was also looking for an engineer at the time and somebody to engineer my whole project and mix it. And my manager was like, yo, you know how to do it. Why don't you just do it?
Mm.
So I was like, you're right. I was like, all right, I do know how to do this. So it's even more personal, because I wrote 85% of my album. I recorded it myself. I engineered it. I mixed it, mastered it, everything. So it's even
You're going to get all the checks.
You know? I like checks. I do. So it's even more personal to me. And I'm just like, I love the respect aspect of it. Like when my team could say, like, this is what she did. And it just feels good, because I took time out to learn how to do that stuff myself. I flew to Atlanta. My cousins taught me how to record and engineer myself and mix. And I surrounded myself with a bunch of really great people. So my ears just became more trained. So I feel really great about it. And the music is fucking bomb. Sorry. Can I curse?
Yes, you can. Because you are a vegan.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So vegans get
all types
of
passes.
Yes, we get special treatment.
Okay. All right. Special F-bombs for me over here.
Nope. Unless you eat some spinach.
That is so funny.
Yes.
But yeah, it's so good. And I feel really, really great about it. And I just feel really confident.
So how would you describe your sound?
It is a breath of fresh air. It really is. And it's just honest. It's so honest. Mm. All my music before has been very good, but surface level good. It was no, I feel like, depth into it. Like, you would listen to it and be like, okay, this is a dope record, but would you listen to this on your worst day?
Okay.
And my album is like that. It's like, I'm going to take you through my worst days, but I'm going to also take you to the ending where it's like, you know what? I can't be broken anymore. I'm tired of being this girl. Right. I'm on to something new.
Okay.
So, not so broken anymore, but we're going to let people see that real quick.
And real quick, I know you do a lot of work. You do a lot of philanthropy, a lot of work with young girls.
Yeah.
So, them seeing you now, after listening to this new album that you're going to put out and seeing you now, what is a message you want to give to them?
Just be yourself. And love yourself before you try and attempt to love anybody else, because we all, like I said, we try to run from that brokenness, and people don't realize a lot of issues that you have within yourself is going to be passed on to somebody else until you fix what is inside of you. Absolutely. People don't like to get to the root of the problem. They like to surpass that and just be like, oh yeah, we love each other. And then it's like, yeah, once that high is over, like, that real stuff is going to come out, and it's like, do I love you as much? Do you love me as much? Do I love me? Like, what's going on? So my message to every young girl, every female, because young or old, I've met some women that still don't know who they are, 40 plus. True. So it's like, figure out how to be alone, how to be by yourself and okay with that, and how to heal and patch up your brokenness. Because you don't got to be broken forever, and you can choose to be a different person than you were yesterday at any time.
Renewed daily.
All right. I'm feeling it. Yeah, I'm feeling it on this day.
See?
So, what, is it the veganism?
Yes.
Is it the vegan?
Yes, it is.
The vegan glow rubbing off?
Yes. But I will say, too, like, the whole vegan wave, like, it makes my brain even feel sharper.
Absolutely.
And more in tune. And, like, it really just helps.
Mm-hmm.
It really does.
Y'all not gonna let it go.
No.
Tell them where they can find you, your music, and anything that you have going on.
Yes. Well, I have a single that is on iTunes right now, but my album is coming very, very soon. It will be on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, all that good stuff. So you guys gotta support it too.
Of course.
Absolutely.
Send it on over to the L-Spot. We love that stuff.
Yes.
We love to showcase the
music, to
network and be recognized.
Yes.
All right. So everyone, make sure you keep following LeA Robinson. Keep following the L-Spot Show. And we'll be right back.
Wait a second. I forgot to get my socials.
Oh, okay.
Hold
on.
Twitter and Instagram at the LeA Robinson, and Facebook and YouTube.com/ I am LeA Robinson. Bam.
Yes. Bam.
We'll be right back.
All right, guys. I hope you had a great time with us on the L-Spot
yes.
Show. I hope you got all the facts about
all
being vegan. I don't think I could eat meat anymore without this girl coming in my ear. All right. So I might have to step on over to the vegan side.
Come on over.
Baby steps, though. Maybe once a week. I'm going to be that flexing vegan,
yes.
like LeA Robinson said.
Yes.
And we had a great conversation with her. She's such a beautiful soul.
Beautiful.
Make sure you guys keep tuning into the L-Spot Show so you could see her new music, because we'll have it. All right. And thank you guys for joining us on this episode. This is Camille J.
And I'm Angela Yvonne.
Make sure you keep tuning into the L-Spot Show so you too can network and be recognized.
Yes.
Okay, with the shimmer.
Vegan shimmer.
No music.
You gonna love this.
I can't believe where I'm at now. I dreamt about this for a while. I knew I'd be a superstar. Didn't think I was gonna make it far. Been through trials and tribulations. Almost lost faith, thought I wouldn't make it.